This is a shader. It's programmed with Skia shader language, which is a shader language that compiles down to run on the GPU and it runs across all platforms with all the frameworks and such. So it's running through Skia for Delphi. Now to show you, this is not pre-recorded, which it looks like in person. It looks like it's pre-recorded because it is 4K and incredibly smooth, which it's not going to come right way through the webinar, but it interacts with my mouse. So as I move my mouse, you can see it's interacting with it, which kind of makes it look a little jerky, and I don't know if I could smooth that out more, but anyway, there it is. The program here, let me change myself down here a little smaller. The way it works is, here's the shader language, and I can load in different shaders. I have a collection of these. All this will be posted. Fractal Pyramid. It's kind of cool. This one doesn't interact with the mouse. And there's a lot of these here. They're all cool, I think. Let me load in Flame. That one's also really cool. The crazy thing is, this is just math. this looks so cool. So, what are shaders? Let me go ahead and jump over here. I have some browser windows open. So, shader language is a programming language for shader effects. You can use these, you can apply it to other videos, to text, to images, etc. Here's the Wikipedia page on it. The most popular shader language is GL shader language, which is OpenGL. The problem is it's specific to OpenGL. So if you want a shader language that works on Vulkan or Metal or whatever, you can't use GL shader language. But you can use Skia shader language. I will do a shout out here. Eric Van Bilsen has an excellent introduction to shader programming. So check that out if you're wanting more information. I do have all of my code for this sample is going to be on GitHub. It'll be public when you see this, hopefully. If not, check back later. And it may get folded into Skia for Delphi eventually. I don't know that my code's up to quality standards for their repository yet, but all of my shaders are going to be in here as well. I do have a document here, which is an overview of the differences between Skia shader language and GL shader language. I pulled this from some Google Docs I found, but I've made some changes and additions to it as well. And Google does have, here's their documentation on shaders. I found that this isn't complete. This isn't everything you need to know. So I found this other book here that's the Book of Shaders. That's a guide through developing shaders. I'm pretty sure between Eric's intro to shader programming and this one, you can learn the basics of shaders and then learn how to make it work with Skia. Now, to show you where I got my shaders and how to adopt a shader to work in Skia shader language, I'm going to go out here to Shader Toy. And there's other websites that have shaders on them, but this is like the main hub, as far as I've seen, that has a bunch of shaders on it. People can come here and post their shaders. Other people can download them, look at them, etc. If you see this warning here, that just means the shader is very intensive and you can't see the preview here, whereas this one, I see the preview here. I'm going to take this shader, though, and convert it to work in Skia shader language. One note is, when I'm looking at for a shader to convert, I look to see if it has other channels down here and such. Now, you can do those in Skia shader language, but they're a little more effort, and I haven't mastered that part yet. So I'm going to do this one because it doesn't have that. Another thing that is something you'll run into is macros. You usually see like pound define things here. You can convert those to either constants or functions, depending on what they are, or inline them, or however you need to deal with them. But macros don't appear to be supported in Skia shader language. So I'm going to grab this, and I'm going to go to Skia shaders playground and paste it in here. Now, right off the bat, if I run this, it's going to give me an error message. The minimum error I'm going to get is missing main function. And that's because in GL shader language, it uses main image. But in Skia shader language, you use main. And instead of passing frag color as an out parameter, it's instead the result. So I just change it like this and then come down to the bottom and change frag color to a return. And hit run. And it works.
I want to...
I usually include this in here so I can remember where it came from. And make sure I'm attributing it. It already has their name on there, but I like to be explicit. One note, though, is both here and on here, they have these inputs that are coming into the shader. So these are variable decorations, and they're being used in here. So when I scroll down here, we see right there, iTime is being used. And I think all of them, there's iResolution. All of them use iTime and iResolution. The rest of them are occasionally used. When you're importing this into your own shader language application, these aren't assumed. These are only assumed on the Playground sites, so you need to include those. So if I go back to my application here, let's run it and bring open the editor. I have those already at the top, so let's just copy this here. Okay, erase that, make sure I don't have the extra thing. It doesn't understand tabs, but that's all right. And I hit run. Oh, it worked! awesome. So, there we go. There is a new shader been imported from GL Shader Language into Skia Shader Language on Skia for Delphi. One of the cool things about Skia Shader Language is it works across all platforms. It doesn't require OpenGL or any special drivers to be installed on the platform. So if it's the platform running Vulkan or Metal or whatever, Skia Shader Language works. Show you the Delphi code here. So I have a SK animated paint box on my form. I turn off the animation. I then load it from the memo, and I also pass in a string. This gets any error messages. So if I get an error message, I just check for that and display it. If there are no error messages, then I create a paint by calling create, and then I have it make for shader. I will point out this is kind of cool. There's a make for Blender as well, which I haven't messed with yet, but that looks like a lot of fun. Then I set the duration on the paint box to max double, which is the biggest value it can be, which basically means run forever. If your shader does have a runtime, then you can change that or specify it here. Call redraw and then turn animate to true. Inside here, I have a event handler on animation draw. I check to see if I have a shader and paint box defined. If I do, then I look to see if it has these uniform input variables. If it does, I pass values in for it. And then on mouse move, I do the same thing for iMouse. That's it. That's all there is to it. Oh, one more thing I want to show is in here with shaders on Windows, you want to set global use Skia raster when available to false, because for shaders on Windows, they work better if you do that. So you don't have to do that, but they will be faster and work better on Windows. You don't have to do this, but because everything I'm doing is Skia, but I think it's a good idea anyway, and that just uses Skia for the rest of the FireMonkey stuff. And this also works in VCL, but since this is a FireMonkey application, it works across all FireMonkey platforms they want to deploy it to. I haven't messed with it or tested it on there, but in theory, it should work. And there we go. That's a quick intro to Skia Shader Language with Skia for Delphi.